A holistic pharmacist.
That's right.
What is a holistic pharmacist?
Well, the type of practice that I'm involved in is more holistically oriented, so I like to encourage people to eat healthy, use supplements to complement their lifestyle. So it's just really the type of focus of my practice.
So what do we need to get into our diets when we are getting to that point where the days are short,
yes,
it's dark
we get
and
into
dreary?
That tough time of year.
Yes.
Well, the Canadian Health Food Association, we're celebrating Natural Health Products Week right now, and as we were leading up to this special event, they did a national survey to look at some strategies Canadians are going to embark on to stay healthy. And great news, more Canadians are going to be consuming more leafy greens, kale and spinach and broccoli. And that's fantastic because these foods are loaded with a lot of vitamins, minerals and nutrients to support immune system and overall health this time of year.
And we hear a lot about vitamin D when it comes
to this
time of year, particularly on the West Coast where we are so sunlight depleted. How important is it to get it through your diet and supplements?
Well, the reality is you can't get enough through diet. It's
okay.
Just impossible. We do make vitamin D when the sun hits our skin, the UVB rays, but this time of year, it's not possible. So that's where a supplement is really critical. Certainly eat foods that have some vitamin D, like mushrooms, eggs, and fortified foods, but vitamin D supplements are really critical. And in the survey, it was pointed out that about 55% of Canadians are thinking about supplementing with vitamin D. Great for infants, children, everybody of all ages really needs to think about vitamin D supplements.
Is there such thing as too much?
It's very difficult to get too much vitamin D.
Okay.
The upper tolerable limit set by Health Canada is 4,000 units a day. So it is a lot. And it's one of those nutrients that has so many effects, so many beneficial effects on health. It's good for bone health, immune system.
And it can even affect your mood, I hear.
It can. It
right.
can.
That's
in fact,
great.
Low vitamin D may be associated with depression. So I have some fish, omega-3 fatty acids, which came out top of list when we were looking at, in the survey, what British Columbians are going to add more of in their diet or supplement. Omega-3 fatty acids contain beneficial fats that help to support our brain, joint health, immune system function as well. We need to have at least 2 servings a week to get that optimal amount.
Right.
And again, that's where supplements can complement the diet if you want to make sure you're getting that consistent amount.
Now, some people say that it's got the fishy taste, and most of these now have the technology that
exactly.
don't.
The technology has so improved over the last few years. So if you pop into a health food store, you'll find options, liquids, capsules, gummies, all kinds of options.
I actually take this one right here.
Yeah, no, it's great. And
no,
my son
burpees.
My son's on fish oil and never complains that it tastes fishy. And then the other supplement category that really came up top of list when we were looking at what Canadians are going to do to stay healthy, it's probiotics. And probiotics, which the yogurt contains the beneficial bacteria that help to support digestive health, also immune system health, and in fermented foods. You'll find some interesting ways to get probiotics today. There are probiotic gums, there's probiotic tablets, capsules. And with probiotics, think not just digestion, but also immune system support.
Right.
So really important, again, this time of year, one of those strategies to help just fortify your defenses.
It's kind of a catchphrasy thing for many people that don't understand the science behind it. We hear antibiotic, and then we hear probiotic.
Are the good bacteria.
Right.
Antibiotics kill bacteria, but while they destroy the bacteria, they also destroy the good bacteria. And so if you have taken an antibiotic, it's really important to supplement back with a probiotic so that you don't get any of the negative consequences of antibiotics, diarrhea, thrush, yeast, things like that.
Is there an age limit to use probiotics, or is it good for most
ages? Probiotics have actually been shown in research to be beneficial for infants even.
Really?
This particular one, there's studies for infant colic, there's chewable tablets can be used for kids. They have so many wide-ranging benefits, probiotics, so it's a great supplement to consider this time of year.
Great information.
So interesting, Sherry. Also in this survey that the Canadian Health Food Association did, showed that more British Columbians are going to be staying active this winter, which is a great way to help beat the winter blues.
We're good at that
reduce
on the West
stress.
Coast. We
yes.
certainly are. So make sure you stay connected with Sherry. There's how you can follow along on her website and holistic pharmacist.
That's right.
Very fascinating for us. Thank you for being here.
Yeah, thanks so much.
We'll continue this conversation. Such good information. I'm going with the probiotic gum.